Get ready to match the stars from We've Got Each Other, Tom Poston, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, from The Betty White Show, Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn.
How are you? Good. Is everybody okay over here? Is that a fake gardenia you're wearing? It's a fake gardenia, but it's pretty nevertheless, sir.
Thank you very much, yeah. And it was nice of you to call everyone's attention to it.
I was going to hold that up, see?
Hi, kids.
Well, they're in school.
Oh.
My oldest girl might not be in school, so hi, my oldest.
All right. Anything else? Anyone with any personal communication?
Yeah, I have one thing here I'd like to do, if I may.
Yes, sure.
That's all right. I'd like to say hi to Connie Chung, because Richard wants to meet her, and this is the only way I can set it up between them.
Yeah.
Connie Chung?
CBS News.
Yes, I do. Now, I remember when she was in New York.
She might be here.
I saw her first in New York.
Well, I'm going to change my name to Richard King, and then we'll be the Chung King Report.
I got first dibs on her because I saw her when she was in New
York.
You're
married. You're married. I am single, Connie.
Gene is married? Now you tell us.
He was separated for a while.
Listen, would you please greet Christy Piper and Sean Bloom? Now, Christy here is a trans champ. She's won $600 in one game. Ready to carry on?
Ready.
Okay. Sean Bloom, how you feel today?
Pretty good.
Good. She's from Iowa, and she gets the giggle. She's a very happy lady there. All right, we're in the middle. We're beginning with round two. The score at the end of round one was 1-0 in favor of Christy, and we'll continue and see how this game ends after we see about this. Here it is, second and final round. Sean, it's up to you. Oh, you had a little unfinished business you wanted to say hi to somebody?
Yeah, my parents, my brothers and sisters, and everybody that's waiting to hear from me.
Waiting to hear from
you. Yeah.
Yes, okay. Anything you say, Sean. A or B?
A again.
A again. All right. Everyone will participate. Harvey took a huge magnet to the burlesque show when he learned that Sally the stripper's blanks were made out of metal.
What?
Took a huge magnet to the burlesque show when he learned that Sally the stripper's blanks were made out of metal.
What wonderful diction you have.
Thank you. The rain in Spain stays mainly in the play.
The answer I was going to get is already there. Oh, I got it.
Oh, finally, the light. Did you turn the light bonbon over her head? That's it. All right. Here we go. Sean Bloom, you ready?
Yeah.
Well, Charles is writing, but I'll read it while he's finishing up. Harvey took a huge magnet to the burlesque show. You know what they are, don't you? Yes. When he learned that Sally the stripper's blanks were made out of metal.
Those little things, pasties?
Pasties, very good answer.
I wasn't sure what they were called.
But you don't have to use your hands. I mean, well, you just say pasties. You don't have to go,
I wasn't sure.
Pasties. Kind of see that. Just simple answers, all we're looking for there.
He didn't say anything about tossing.
What do you say?
I don't. What would he want with pasties?
What? If they were made out of metal.
What would he want with them? I said pasties.
Yes, I know. He collects them, I guess.
I guess so.
Now, is this a euphemism for pasties? G-string?
No. No. Wrong.
Just the opposite.
That's another thing. Uh-oh. What's it say in the paper, Charles?
Well, it says Connie Chung is missing from the country rather unexpectedly.
Really? She went back, eh?
I said G-strings in the spaceship
number. G-strings in the spaceship number. That was with the full orchestra and all of the dancing girls and everything. Marianne, he took a huge magnet to the burlesque show when he learned that Sally the stripper's pasties were made out of metal, right?
Well, I don't know from personal experience, but I've heard they've been called pasties.
Pasties, right. So that's two for Sean. Richard?
G-strings.
G-strings.
My mind wandered.
Your mind wandered a little bit? Yes.
I said... call me collect anything, dear. Just call me collect.
Call him anything. I said pasties, but I thought those were those little meat pies.
Yes, pasta. That's three for her. Now, Christy, two to tie and three to win. Ready?
Ready.
This is it. Brett, you do not play. Everyone else does.
I'm the only one who got it right. I'd like that stated because it very seldom happens.
That's true. You matched in the first round. Okay. Big Nose Ben has a really big nose. It's so big he has to lift it up to blink. His nose is so big he has to lift it up to blank.
How come I matched?
I forgot what the question was.
I have
too. Just one of those lucky flukes.
Oh, heavens.
That's a good name for a movie star, Lucky Fluke.
That's right.
Trash Groveler. That's a good name.
Excellent. Okay, Christy. Big Nose Ben has a really big nose. It's so big he has to lift it up to blank.
Blow it.
Yeah! Has to lift it up. Blow it. Bing. Okay, now she needs two to tie and three to win. Tom?
Oh, get out. I get out. I said lift it up to walk. I
lift it up to walk.
Yeah.
Now, wait a minute. You are wrong, audience. That is not a bad answer. Brett,
I don't play.
I don't play because I got it right.
All right, just get off my back.
Whoa!
Whoa, that's 3-2 the score. Need one more for a tie. Mary Ann. Uh-oh.
I heard an uh-oh in the audience.
Uh-oh.
Oh. Blow!
Nice score. One more.
Sniff or smell.
Sniff or smell. Right? Okay. All right. Score is still tied, Betty. It's up to you.
Smells.
Okay. So there we go. The game ended in a tie. We'll tell you about a tie right after we tell you about this. What are you doing here, turning on the camera when my back is turned like that when I'm walking back to my position and you turn on the camera? Hello there, ladies.
Hello.
Here we go. Now, let's see. First, we have to turn off the lights. Then we push the button and reveal one tie-breaking question for each. The one who scored the most will be the winner. Sean, you have a choice of A or B.
I've gone with A. I'll stick with A.
It is all the way. A all the way. Moses said, he says, I've really been in a daze. I thought I saw the handwriting on the wall. Then I realized I was in the blank. Moses said that.
I never did think you were so ugly.
Moses.
Moses said, I've really been in the daze. I thought I saw the handwriting on the wall. Then I realized I was in the blank.
You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille.
Okay. Come on, Brett Charles, let's go.
I got it, honey. I'm finished. Speak to him.
Sean, Moses said, I've really been in a daze. I thought I saw the handwriting on the wall, then I realized I was in the blank.
Restroom.
Restroom. Yeah! She said restroom.
No, I didn't.
You didn't.
But we're going to have a match. Ha ha.
Laboratory. All right.
Aren't there walls in a John?
Yes.
Well, let me see.
You didn't understand the question.
I saw the handwriting on
She matched once this year.
I said water and all lotion, lake, river, or bulrushes. You're all this all.
I've really been in the days. I thought I saw the handwriting on the wall, then I realized I was in the bulrushes.
Because there are no walls.
Brett.
That is terrible migraine.
Poor girl. Yes, sirree.
Look well, good in got the rushes, figure. Gene.
Yes, terrific in the rushes. Yes, you're a good trooper. Charles.
Connie Chung wanted her for the matron of honor, too. John,
there's another match. Let's shoot for Sean. All right, Mary Ann. I thought I saw the handwriting on the wall, then I realized I was in the...
I've matched twice.
That's, well, we can't expect any more of you.
That's right.
We'll just move on.
I said tub.
Tub, right. Richard, where is this handwriting on the wall?
I know. It was really...
Tub. No, very, very interesting. Almost up there with ocean, river,
bull rushes.
Yeah.
And John.
John. All right, that's three for Sean. Yeah. Do you know Connie Chung?
Connie John.
Connie John, right. Okay. Well, she did four. That means in order for you to beat her, you've got to do five. However, if you do four, you get another tie. Judy said, I think my doctor is a vampire. He tried to pierce my ears with blank. I think my doctor is a vampire. He tried to pierce my ears with blank.
Gene?
Yes, sir?
Is Connie Chung married?
Is Connie Chung married? You know, I don't know.
Now listen, I don't want her name bantered around like that.
Well, we're not bantering about her name.
Well, I America.
Oh, yeah, everybody knows who Connie Chung is.
She's an excellent anchorwoman. They do know who she is.
Well, now, she was a network CBS.
She was on network for many years.
She was a network. She was in New York. She was in Washington. Right, and now she's local here in New York in the news department there.
And she's very good. Richard's an anchorman. Or is that anchorman?
Christy. Judy said, I think my doctor is a vampire. He tried to pierce my ears with blank.
His fangs.
His fangs. Okay. Now let's see if we get any fangs over here.
It's a fangless job.
A fangless job. Yes.
I said teeth.
Teeth. Okay, you're right. We got one there. One for her. Brett?
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Score is now 4-2. Charles?
El Fangle.
4-3 is the score. One more set of bicuspids or incisors, and we get a match, a game. Show and tell.
Show and tell?
Right.
Fangs are
cast. Okay, tie score. Now, Richard, you match. She wins it.
Takes two to Fango.
That's right. All right, five. All right, there you are. This spot is yours, and we'll get back to you in a second while we say goodbye to Sean Bloom. You're a wonderful, happy lady, and we've got lots of gifts for you.
Thank you very much, Sean Bloom.
Thank you for being with us here on Match Game 77. There she goes, and while we're spinning her off, we're going to spin a message or two just for you. Thank you, Johnny O. Here we are. Christy's up here for the second time. She's got her $700 now, and she's going to try for over $5,000. And we'll go by beginning up here and pointing out to you, Christy, that not too long ago, we polled a bunch of people in this studio, and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Blank ointment. And the answer they gave most frequently is worth $500 to you if you match it. And for matching the second most popular answer, you get $250 and $100 for matching the third. And three of our six celebrities will help you.
Richard, please.
Fly in the ointment is a good one.
Betty, please.
Oh, Betty, who was...
Betty, please.
I'm not a spider in the ointment.
No.
That's ridiculous.
Well, if there's a fly there, there could be a spider.
I'm hoping that something will come.
An answer will come to you.
There must be something.
That's what you're waiting for.
Zinc.
Zinc ointment.
Everything in the kitchen, zinc. Right, zinc ointment.
Zinc ointment.
The winner, Anthony Quinn, shoes of a fisherman.
Okay, you need one more.
Tom.
Tom. The third position is very difficult, so just think about it for a second, and maybe an answer will come to you from outer space.
Blue.
Blue ointment? Yes. Some Martian. Blue ointment? Sing it.
Just go on with it. Go on. You'll just regret it. Just get on with it, please.
Blue ointment.
Bluer than the blue.
Bluer than the...
ointment and the ointment.
Oh, madness! Hello there, Christy. Now you got blue ointment. Fly in the ointment, and you got zinc ointment. Which cure would you like? Come to my dressing room.
They're all so terrific.
Yes, you may have a better one in your own little head. No, you don't, do you?
I can tell that.
Is that a touch of sarcasm? They're all so terrific?
Yes.
Let's hear a winner from you then, Chris.
A and D.
A&D ointment. Now, wait a minute. That happens to be a marvelous palliative, a soothing thin for minor skin abrasions and contusions and facial cuts
and
zits and diaper rash.
It's good for babies.
Yeah. Right.
Well, I'm going to be very surprised if it's up there, that's all.
You will, would you like to make a little
side bet? Wager.
I'll bet you a nickel that it's up there.
You're on. Let's go.
It's up there somewhere.
Let's go.
All right. May we see, you've peeked. May we see the bottom one, please? Baby ointment? Well, that's A&D ointment.
That ain't.
May we see the next one, please? Rubbing ointment. Aren't these great answers that you all thought of?
They were in trouble, too.
All right. We're looking for A&D. Slide it, please. Flying the... Yeah. Okay. Now...
Christy, ye of little faith.
I owe him a nickel, right. Christy just reminded me I owe you a nickel. Now, Christy, you've picked up a little extra cash here. You got $700, and you're going to meet another player. Let's welcome Dave Clark. Dave Clark. Hello, Dave. There you go. As soon as it stops. Thank you. We'd like to find out a little bit about you, Dave Clark, before we begin.
I live in Running Springs, California, up in the San Bernardino Mountains.
Yeah.
Married to the most wonderful gal in the world, Gail.
Yeah.
Got three good children, David, Michelle, and Michael.
Right.
And they're all fantastic.
You look like a very happy fellow. Good for you.
Just nervous.
All right. Nothing to be nervous about. We're a friendly bunch. Dave, you may have A or B.
B.
B it is. Dave Clark there. Horrible Hank is so horrible.
How horrible is he?
He's the only person in the world that brushes his teeth with a blink brush. That's how horrible he is. Only person in the world brushes his teeth with
horrible Hank.
Only person in the world brushes his teeth with a blank brush.
Blah. Blank brush. You got me, hon.
Right.
I'm gonna go for horrible.
Okay, horrible. Okay.
Wait a minute.
Oh, you think that's okay?
That's okay.
Well, you're all right, Gene.
I'm okay. Dave Clark. Horrible Hank is so horrible, he's the only person in the world that brushes his teeth with a blank brush.
Wire brush.
Wire brush. Okay. I think you missed the point there, Dave. I said horrible Hank. Tom, what do you say?
Well, I said that he brushed his teeth with a bowl brush.
There, that would be horrible. Brett?
I said he brushed his teeth with a shoe brush.
That would be horrible also. Charles?
Johnny brush.
Johnny brush is terrible. That seems to be the response, Dave. What do you say there?
Well, I say that Running Springs is really a beautiful city. I've been there many times, and I love it.
Good.
But talking about horrible?
Yes.
I really thought horrible, and I said Johnny Brush.
Okay. That seems to be the response.
Well, I have been to Johnny Brush, and it is beautiful.
Yes.
I said scrub.
Scrub brush. Gesundheit, my dear.
Sorry.
Show us your answer there, and we'll
see
what
you... With a hairbrush.
A hairbrush would be terrible. So there's how it goes, Dave. You win some, you lose some. Now we've got this for you, a winner if there ever was one. Well, here's the way it is. The next time we get together in this very studio, some of these people will be absent. Sorry to say.
Well, there's a fly in the ointment right there.
That's right. Or a spider in the ointment, as the saying goes. Oh, let's see. One is missing already.
Oh.
Oh, she's coming back. There she is. These are the people who'll be here.
Ron Colillo, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flyer.
So join us next time for Match Game 77. I'm Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.
Unsweetened.
When you guys taste these, you're going to sh**.
Unapologetic.
What is that?
It's a baby bag.
A baby bag. $1,000?
Come on, lighten up.
I feel like I do everything.
From the producers of Tori and Dean comes an unflinching look.
I don't know. I'm not sure. I'm too scared.
At an unorthodox woman.
They're going to freak out when they see it.
They're going to freak out.
Carney Wilson Unstapled, a new reality show, Thursday night at 8, 7 Central, only on GSN.
Eat your heart out!
One more.
Sniff or smell.
Sniff or smell. Right? Okay. All right. Score is still tied, Betty. It's up to you.
Smells.
Okay. So there we go. The game ended in a tie. We'll tell you about a tie right after we tell you about this. What are you doing here, turning on the camera when my back is turned like that when I'm walking back to my position and you turn on the camera? Hello there, ladies.
Hello.
Here we go. Now, let's see. First, we have to turn off the lights. Then we push the button and reveal one tie-breaking question for each. The one who scored the most will be the winner. Sean, you have a choice of A or B.
I've gone with A. I'll stick with A.
It is all the way. A all the way. Moses said. He says, I've really been in a daze. I thought I saw the handwriting on the wall. Then I realized I was in the blank. Moses said that.
I never did think you were so ugly.
Moses.
Moses said, I've really been in the daze. I thought I saw the handwriting on the wall. Then I realized I was in the blank.
You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille.
Okay. Come on, Brett Charles, let's go.
I got it, honey. I'm finished. Speak to him.
Sean, Moses said, I've really been in a daze. I thought I saw the handwriting on the wall. Then I realized I was in the blank.
Gene is married. Now you tell us.
He was separated for a while.
Listen. Would you please greet Christy Piper and Sean Bloom? Now, Christy here is a champion. She's won $600 in one game. Ready to carry on?
Ready.
Okay. Sean Bloom, how you feel today?
Pretty good.
Good. She's from Iowa, and she gets the giggle. She's a very happy lady there. All right, we're in the middle. We're beginning with round two. The score at the end of round one was 1-0 in favor of Christy, and we'll continue and see how this game ends after we see about this. Here it is, second and final round, Sean. It's up to you. Oh, you had a little unfinished business you wanted to say hi to somebody?
Yeah, my parents, my brother, my brothers and sisters, and everybody that's waiting to hear from me.
Waiting to hear from
you?
Yeah. Yes, okay. Anything you say, Sean. A or B?
A again.
A again. All right, everyone will participate. Harvey took a huge magnet to the burlesque show when he learned that Sally the stripper's blanks were made out of metal.
What?
Took a huge magnet to the burlesque show when he learned that Sally the stripper's blanks were made out of metal.
What wonderful diction you have, dear.
Thank you. The rain in Spain stays mainly in the plain.
The answer I was going to get is already there. Oh, I got it.
Oh, finally, the light. Did you turn the light bulb on over her head? That's it. All right. Here we go. Sean Bloom, you ready?
Yeah.
Well, Charles is writing, but I'll read it while he's finishing up. Harvey took a huge magnet to the burlesque show. You know what they are, don't
you?
Yes. When he learned that Sally the stripper's blanks were made out of metal.
Those little things, pasties?
Pasties, very good answer.
Sure what they were called.
But you don't have to use your hands. I mean, well, you just say, you don't have to go.
Well, I wasn't sure.
Pasties. You kind of see that. Just simple answers, all we're looking for there.
He didn't say anything about tossing.
What do you say?
I don't. What would he want with pasties?
What? If they were made out of metal.
What would he want with them? I said pasties.
Yes, I know. He collects them, I guess.
I guess so.
Is this a euphemism for pasties, G-string?
No. No. Wrong. Just the opposite. That's another thing. Uh-oh. What's it say in the paper, Charles?
Well, it says Connie Chung is missing from the country rather unexpectedly.
Really? She went back, eh?
I said G-strings in the spaceship
number. G-strings in the spaceship number. That was with the full orchestra and all of the dancing girls and everything. Marianne. He took a huge magnet to the burlesque show when he learned that Sally the stripper's pasties were made out of metal, right?
Well, I don't know from personal experience, but I've heard they've been called pasties.
Pasties, right. So that's two for Sean. Richard?
G-strings.
G-strings.
My mind wandered.
Your mind wandered a little bit? Yes.
I said...
Call me collect anything, dear. Just call me.
Call him anything. I said pasties, but I thought those were those little meat pies.
Yes, pasta. That's three for her. Now, Christy, two to tie, three to win. Ready?
Ready.
This is it. Brett, you do not play. Everyone else does.
I'm the only one who got it right. I'd like that stated because it very seldom happens.
That's true. You matched in the first round. Okay. Big Nose Ben has a really big nose. It's so big he has to lift it up to blink. His nose is so big he has to lift it up to blank.
How come I matched?
I forgot what the question was.
I have
too. It was just one of those lucky flukes.
Oh, heavens.
That's a good name for a movie star, Lucky Fluke.
That's right.
Trash Groveler. That's a good name.
Excellent. Okay, Christy. Big Nose Ben has a really big nose. It's so big he has to lift it up to blank.
Blow it.
Yeah! Has to lift it up. Good. Bing. Okay, now she needs 2 to tie and 3 to win. Tom?
Oh, get out. I get out. I said lift it up to walk.
Lift it up to walk.
Yes.
Now, wait a minute. You are wrong, audience. That is not a bad answer. Brett,
I don't play.
I don't play because I got it right.
All right, just get off my back.
Whoa!
Whoa, that's 3-2 the score. Need one more for a tie. Mary Ann. Uh-oh.
I heard an uh-oh in the audience.
Uh-oh.
Oh. Blow!
Nice score.
Get ready to match the stars from We've Got Each Other, Tom Poston, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, from the Betty White Show, Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Bunny Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn.
How are you? Good. Is everybody okay over here? Is that a fake gardenia you're wearing? It's a fake gardenia, but it's pretty nevertheless, sir.
Thank you very much, yeah. And it was nice of you to call everyone's attention to it.
I was going to hold that up, see?
Hi, kids.
Well, they're in school.
Oh.
My oldest girl might not be in school, so hi, my oldest.
All right. Anything else? Anyone with any personal communication?
Yeah, I have one thing here I'd like to do, if I may.
Yes, sure.
That's all right. I'd like to say hi to Connie Chung, because Richard wants to meet her, and this is the only way I can set it up between them.
Yeah. Connie Chung?
CBS News.
Yes, I do, and I remember when she was in New York.
She might be here.
I saw her first in New York.
Well, I'm going to change my name to Richard King, and then we'll be the Chung King Report.
I got first dibs on her because I saw her when she was in New York.
You're married. I am single, Connie.